but it's 2020. I ain't finna argue about twerking.
Mayday, mayday, motherfucking mayday. Female rappers have cracked the code to take over the rap industry. And I love to see it. What's good, it's your boy Stacy, and we're gonna talk about some things. But if you're new to the page, you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe right now, like this shit up, comment as well, and make sure you ring that bell. Let's get into it. Listen, the last 2 years has been a stick up, a changing of guards. The women are straight up taking over the rap game. We all know the queen, Nicki Minaj, has been doing her time for the last 10 plus, but after a long struggle for relevancy when it comes to a variety of women in rap killing shit, we are finally seeing the balance. Well, to be honest, sometimes the scale tips over to the ladies. And the craziest thing is, the answer has been under our nose this whole time. And what is it, you ask me? Simply shaking that ass. Megan Thee Stallion, who has formidable skills behind the mic, blasted on the scene last year. Although her breakout single, Big Old Freak, was going crazy, it was the viral challenge we at the station that really made it take off.
We're out here. At the station.
When the world seen how Meg moved those cheeks, it was a done deal, we had a new star. From that point on, Meg has kept pretty much the same formula to push music, and I ain't mad at her. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. But since then, Meg has been killing this shit commercially. She's had 24 singles chart, including Big Old Freak, which went gold, and two records that are not certified platinum. Hot Girl Summer featuring Ty Dolla Signs and Nicki Minaj, as well as her single Cash Shit featuring the baby. And this shit has been contagious across the music industry. Artists all around are using the same tactic to promote music. I'm from Miami, Dade County, the 305, home of Uncle Luke, bass music, booty shaking. We some dancing ass niggas, I can't lie.
Is this Spider-Man with the Hennessy bottle? My God, it is. Oh, and he's sticking, bopping, and juking.
But the Miami rap scene is seeing a crazy surge of new female artists. All sparked, of course, from the hometown duo, the City Girls, who splashed on the scene in 2017 with their hit single, Fuck That Nigga. Now don't get me wrong, the City Girls music did not blow because it's twerking and dancing to the music. It was the actual content that was being discussed in their music that perked the ears of women in the city. And then it was Florida. And then it was the whole nation. But that's another story. But to keep it short, the appetite for wanting to hear women talk they shit was rising. The ladies' mouths were watering. So when Megan Thee Stallion came on the scene talking that shit and throwing that ass simultaneously, the woman was eating that shit up. And I sat back and watched and seen how the whole thing affected my city locally. Two artists in particular shot their shot, and that bitch hit all net. Tierra Trenise and Jayla Anderson. In a relatively short amount of time, these ladies have found themselves getting spins on the radio. And in Miami, that is a huge deal for local artists because this is a tourist hub. So you usually hear the music from all over, but these ladies made it happen. Now the last thing I want anyone to do is to disrespect these women when it comes to their artistry, because they are no slouches when it comes to their pen and their abilities behind the mic. But I want to highlight how they blew past a lot of female MCs that are talented down here. And it's a few reasons, but mostly it's because of their use of their total package and of course, timing. Because we all know timing is everything. Well before deciding to make music, Tierra Trenise was respected as a poet. From time to time, she'll drop freestyles and fire challenges and straight up kill that shit.
Uchi Wally, he steady calling me mommy. I'm steady saying I'm single, but all of my exes calling, they all wanna be friends. They begging me for a chance when they realize they new hoe can't do it no hands.
It wasn't until one day that she decided that she wanted to take rap seriously and recorded her smash hit, Fool Me Once, which was produced by young Miami legend Ripper De La Hoya. Once the single was released, she didn't hold back. She didn't wait for support. She took matters into her own hands and did whatever that was necessary to push her single. Which takes me to Jayla Anderson. In Miami, Jayla has been growing in front of our eyes as an artist. But from day one, her charisma and energy was second to none. She possesses the natural ability to push her music. You become a fan of her songs by just watching her enjoy them, whether it's twerking or just being live. Now every time the song is played, images of her getting lit comes in your head and ladies all around begin to follow suit. All in all, these ladies are smart. This shit is cerebral, but it's all simple math. For example, go to your favorite IG models page. You'll see straight up that the amount of likes and comments that a headshot gets will pale in comparison to ass shots. But most women look at it like this. The ass brought you here, but the vibes kept you here. And it's been the same thing when it comes to these artists' music. And we can't blame them, because the men has been doing the same damn thing. Artists like Mike Jones, who's a Texas native, said that he found his bed breaking in a strip club by going to strippers and asking could he make songs for them to come out to. In Atlanta, the rap supergroup Migos said that they went to strip clubs to break music just about every day. There's even situations where artists who have paid IG models to twerk their songs to help break them. All because twerking is contagious, and it's the easiest indicator to let you know that your song is good if somebody can throw that ass to it. If you get a woman to dance to your song, you got some. The ladies are the A&Rs of the industry. In the song Buried Alive, Kendrick Lamar tells a story where he has a conversation with arguably the biggest rapper in the game, Drake. He stated that him and Drizzy discuss how the women be the tastemakers for the shit we're making. Now, if the two biggest artists in the world been peak game, you gotta understand, it is what it is. Female artists have taken the sexualization of women in hip-hop and flipped it for their own advantage, while also gaining power as opposed to being demoralized before. Back in the days, we saw women being sexy and dancing for men in music videos, being somewhat servants. Nowadays, women are making music videos look like a girl's night out. And I must admit, this is the most powerful that I've ever seen women in hip-hop. I can link with my friend, we get in the car and we ride and listen to rap. And the whole time, it could be not one dude that pop up the whole entire time. The ladies are proud, confident, fearless. But is there any negative impact that we may see from this renaissance? It's been shown in the past that the worst thing is to rely on is gimmicks or fabs, because gimmicks can get old and fabs can change. While these ladies have this attention, I'm hoping that they take their artistry to the next level, become all around great MCs, songwriters, and businesswomen. And I'm begging y'all, please don't make these whack ass songs and think you just twerk to that shit, we gonna vibe that shit. Cause we gonna watch, but that's gonna be it. Cause we'll politely keep on scrolling and not press not nan link. Trying to tell you. But hey man, let's enjoy this shit for how it is right now. Women, gotta give it up to y'all. Y'all killing it and I'm loving every bit of it. I love to see it. Keep doing your thing, you know? Thank you for listening to my story. Like this shit up. Comment if you have any more thoughts. You want to talk about some shit, you know, let me know. You feel me? Subscribe if you're new to the page, man. It's your boy Stacy. Now, in the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and hop on IG and check my timeline to see if Med drops some new shit for a nigga like, you know, enjoy by myself with some lotion. It's quarantine time, man. Like, I ain't got no shame in my game.